Ladies and gentlemen, this is Barry Michaels, TV ringside, main event of the evening. Fighting out of the blue corner, the Tiger, Max Bursak.
As we can see, Max Bursak on the right. He's from Ukraine. That's the same place as the Klitschko brothers, World Heavyweight Champions. They bring him up there.
Zach Dunn, the local bloke.
He's got the house behind him tonight. Don't you worry about that. He's got a full house behind him, and they all want to see him with that belt around his waist, Brad.
Arguably the biggest test in that young man's career. Bursak, very well managed, very well schooled, knows his way around a boxing ring. Managed very, very wisely and astutely by K2 Promotions, K2 Ukraine, and they've brought the big guns out here tonight with Alexander Krasiuk here as well.
These are Ukraine girls. Here we go. They've got the flags out.
Got some support here too tonight. Great to see Jared Fletcher in the audience too, who beat Max Bursak over in Monaco in February 2014 in what was, I think, one of his best performances.
The third man in the ring, Bruce McTavish.
Yes, world-renowned, world-travelled referee, Bruce McTavish, good friend of mine. I've worked a lot with him overseas in Japan and Thailand.
And he still gets out to the nightclubs.
I don't know about that, but he certainly knows his way around a boxing ring as well. As we watch,
the Tiger. For the Rocky stuff, Eye of the Tiger, Brad. You'll get the Eye of the Tiger here tonight, mate.
We certainly have. The Tiger, Max Bursak. It's Bursak versus Dunn. Australia versus Ukraine.
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent, Zach Dynamo Dunn!
We mentioned the house being full tonight, and we mentioned his... I mean, Zach Dunn's got the whole Australia behind him here tonight in his quest to become a world champion. Here we go, the old Aussie flag. He's got Danny Kaye. You can see Mick Hargraves there as well.
Looks very, very relaxed.
Daryl Ford as well.
Yeah, got the entire team.
The president. Hey, there's a bloke being squint.
He looks very, very relaxed, does the Dynamo Zach Dunn.
Is there a bit of Jeff Harding about him?
Oh, there's a lot of Jeff Harding about him. The hitman, I know he'll be watching tonight with Charlie Lucas up in Sydney. And there he is, the Dynamo, Zach Dunn.
As you mentioned before, it's a bit of an old school feel about these guys. They're not seeking publicity, they're doing it the old school way.
Oh, they do, they shun the publicity. It was hard to get an interview with Zach Dunn. We wanted to try and do an interview with him here tonight, but it was very, very difficult.
Ladies and gentlemen, please have a bit of attention. We are standing for the Ukrainian national anthem.
Come on. And ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the microphone to sing the Australian National Anthem, star of the Ten Tenors and Sweeney Todd, Mr. Ben Clark.
Australians, oh, let us rejoice, for we are young and free. We've golden soil and wealth for toil. Our home is girt by sea. Our land abounds in nature's gifts of beauty. Australia fair, in joyful strains, then let us sing. Advance, Australia fair.
Ladies and gentlemen, tonight's fight sanctioned by the International Boxing Organisation under the auspice of the Professional Boxing and Combat Sports Board of Victoria. Your judges at ringside are David Craig, Churchy Chan's Tricky Cat, and Kriang Sang Chung Hong. Your doctor at ringside is Walter Di Bartolo. Your timekeeper, Mr. Damien Membry, and your referee when that bell tolls is Mr. Bruce McTavish. With thanks to our major sponsor, Gary Simmons, out of Simmons Homes. Both warriors have entered the ring, and this is the main event of the evening. And now, out of the iconic Melbourne and Exhibition Centre, and the viewers watching around Australia on Channel 31, it's Main Event Time! 12 by 3 minute rounds in the super middleweight division. They will be fighting for the IBO Super Middleweight Championship title of the world. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, trained by Ludic Sibenko, wearing all black trunks with an official weight 75.9 kilograms, a fight record 35 fights, 31 wins, 1 draw, 14 ending by way of knockout. This man has never been stopped inside the distance. Representing Kiev in the Ukraine, the Tiger, Max Bursack. And across the ring, his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, trained by Danny Kaye out of the Fighting Lions. Wearing royal blue trunks with white piping, an official weight 75.8 kilograms. A perfect fight record, 17 fights, 17 wins, 15 ending by knockout. This man has an 88% KO record. Representing Melbourne, Victoria, Australia, Zach Dynamo!
You've been given your instructions. Touch gloves, go back to your corner. Touch.
It's main event time here, Channel 31 TV ringside, back in your lounge rooms, and it's a world title fight. What a way to start. Brad Bacall, international referee here as a side commentator. Zach Dunn, he's ready to rock and roll, Brad.
He certainly is. The deck's being cleared as we begin for round number one. That's Zach Dunn in the navy blue trunks with the white band and striping, red gloves, and Max Bursack from the Ukraine in the all black trunks.
This is over 12 rounds at super middleweight for the viewers out there. Super middleweight is 76
kilos. 76.2 kilos, 168
Getting
pounds.
Technical again, Brad.
Oh, it just comes
just
within,
keep it
Pete.
To 76 kilos. Here we go,
nice
Max.
Nice left hook by there, Bursack. By Max Bursack. Beautiful left hand.
We mentioned he's beaten Brian Vera, and he's also gave Martin Murray a real tough fight. So
This
nice
guy's
right
a real world-class fighter.
High-class fighter. This is a real 50-50 fight. There's no favourite in this fight, let me tell you that.
Zach Dunn, as I mentioned before, reminds you a lot of Jeff Hitman Hardy.
He certainly does.
He was a crowd favourite, Jeff Hardy, wasn't he?
He was, yeah. And what a champion he was. There's a nice left hand again by Bursak. Nice left hand by Dunn.
The Dunn family, Craig, how much has invested the time and money to get Zach to this position? And Barry Michaels has done a great job promoting him as well.
Absolutely. It's been a real effort.
Ron Reed on a ring apron, Herald Sun guru. So all the right people are here.
They certainly are. This will be a real arm wrestle for a few rounds, Peter Maniatis. It's going to be a very, very hard fight to find a winner in this first couple of rounds. Styles make fights. Sun, nice, done, nice left hook, right hand, misses. Left hook to the body by Burke. Equal to the task at this particular time.
Both guys really just having a look, you know. Zach bit of a flurry there from Zach.
Yeah, flurry by Bursak to the body, and then Zach backs him up to the ropes.
Third man in the ring, international referee, Bruce McTavish from the Philippines.
Lovely left right hand by Zach, unclubbing right hand to the body. That one certainly caught the attention of Max Bursak. Nice left lead again. Oh, and an over the top right hand by
Bursak. Nice right hand from Zach Dunn.
And referee McTavish warns him to keep his head on the ground, to keep his head off the ground, I should say.
And for the viewers out there, Bruce McTavish was the referee that refereed Jeff Fenwick's first world title fight.
Satoshi Shinyaki, 1985. How's that, Pete?
Your memory's still pretty good. I remember Lester Ellis won the world title around that same time.
Same
as
night.
Well, yeah.
Exactly the same night.
Here we go. Zach Dunn, big body shots.
Nice body shots by Zach Dunn.
I'd say the feeling out process is out the window at the moment now, Brett.
Absolutely. And that's what Zach Dunn needs to do. He gets hit by a right hand there, but he needs to work the body. Great. He's got to slow Bursak down a little bit. Got good hands. Sees punches coming, Bursak.
Dunn now starting to try and put a bit of power behind those punches and try and get some ascendancy. Good fighters, not a respect. You call that break?
Tonight's
Bar Central, the after party from tonight's show is at Bar Central. 162 live on streaming comes. The Custodian invests different. Mr. Mixer, small batch cocktails, and Simmons, the great Australian builder.
First round in the bank. There's that right hand by Bursak. Nice left lead by Bursak. He ties Zach up. Clubbing to the right hand to the back of the head. It wasn't a scoring shot. Beautiful right hand to the body there, Pete.
Certainly was, Brad.
To experience corner there. Daryl Ford, Mick Hargraves, Danny Kaye. Also the cut man.
Yeah, I know him well. Well, John. Been part of that team. That team has stuck together for a long, long time.
Loyalty.
Absolutely.
You call that, Brad?
Absolutely.
Loyalty.
We do. Yep. Through thick and through.
Round number two.
Here we go. Max
beautiful
Bursak
body
just
to the...
comes out to say, "Hey, boy,
welcome to center ring."
Yeah. We're
Zach
starting up again.
Zach equal to the task. Look at the body on Zach Dunn. He's really done the work. Look, he's cut. He's hard. He's got a hard body on for a 24-year-old. Nice right hand by Dunn. How did you see that first round, Peter Maniatis?
I scored it to Zach Dunn. I just thought he was a bit
I did by an
crispier.
Absolute whisper. Just by the power of the punch, the body punches back towards back. The end of the round. Good he work. Actually stole that round.
He did.
Bursak, nice little left hook.
But there was nothing in that round.
Nothing at all. No, nothing at all. Gee, you've got to give Bursak some credit. He's got a nice left hand, Pete, hasn't he? There's a clubbing left hook and a right hand, and Bursak smiles and said, "Come on, what are you doing? You're moving hurt." He won't want to do that too often because, let me tell you, Zach Dunn has got some real power in those hands. Oh, look at the clubbing. Beautiful left hook to the body.
Both fighters now are just starting it.
They're just
away.
Teeing off on each while other
away.
At the moment.
It might as well be a four-round fight. They don't
Absolutely.
Care.
Absolutely.
They're well, both just going for home.
Zach Dunn loves Play a out. Challenge. You put him in front of something and tell him he can't do it, he'll prove you wrong. Oh, there's a double right hand to the rib cage and an uppercut.
Max Bursak from the Ukraine, where the Klitschko brothers are, Kiev.
Managed by the same people, K2 Promotions. They've got the big guns out here tonight. Alexander Krasiuk has come out with Bursak. Nice right hand by Dunn. Geez, work ethic. He's got that work ethic. He stays at it. Whether he's fighting on the back foot, whether he's fighting on the side, he's still throwing punches. Nice left-right hand. Just missed the mark.
Whatever happens here tonight, Zach Dunn's going to learn so much from this opponent.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. That's
this
how you
is
learn.
Where you learn.
Absolutely.
He's going to get 12 world-class rounds.
Win, lose, or draw, he'll be a much better fighter out of tonight's result.
Oh, undoubtedly.
Oh, he gets hit with a nice left hook there. He made a mistake, Zach. Trying to load up too much.
And he tries to come back, showing a lot of heart.
He needs to fight smarter, not harder. He's not going to blast Max Bursak out of there at this early stage of the round. Good round so far by both fighters. Very close round.
Zach Dunn, though, the Aussie spirit. You can just see it in him, can't you?
He's
an Aussie goer.
He's got every part of it. Oh, beautiful left, right, left, right, left, right. And he stands there and admires his work and gets hit for it.
Let him go.
What a fight so far. The work ethic of these two guys. Great sportsmanship.
He's a sensational amateur as well, Brad. He's fought all around the world as an amateur.
Yeah, I have said over 170 fights. And Bursak just talking to Zach Dunn there, says, OK, just break. And
Bursak can't speak English, can he?
Well, he said something to Zach there. I don't know what it was. Oh, and that was a good round. Actually, I think Max Bursak stole that round of Zach Dunn. I actually think by sheer cleaner scoring punches, knuckle part of the glove and the scoring part of the body, well, Zach wailed away and had incredible power. And in a moment, we're going to see some of the action of that last round. Let's have a look at this, Pete. There's the beautiful left lead by Zach Dunn. Two beautiful leads.
That's right.
That missed. That hit the gloves. They both scored with that one.
Big body shot there from Dunn.
That hit home. Winning that exchange. There's the nice lead by Bursak again. There's the left hook. Great hard round to score by their judges. And Bursak just with that little flurry there. There he is again towards the end of the round with that little flurry, that little left and right. That missed. There you go. And I gave him that round by sheer virtue of those last couple of punches.
We're into the third round. Is this fast pace? Is this playing the Bursak's marked up around the temple? Is this fast pace playing the Bursak?
This fast pace will suit Bursak, absolutely, because what he's going to try and do, he's going to try and drive every little bit of energy out of it. Yep. And most boxers will understand what a puncher's psyche is all about. They want to burn as much fuel as they can early, because then they're going to run over them towards the end of the round. And that's what Zach Dunn needs to be aware of, that he's got 12 rounds. He's only been 10 rounds once in his short professional career of 17 fights. He's got power, he needs to be able to use that power.
Zach, as a young kid, would have been dreaming of this moment.
Oh, absolutely. Every young kid dreams of this moment.
He would have been dreaming of this moment right now. Probably at the peak of his powers, too, at 24 years of age, Brad.
Absolutely. And when you look at it, I said, a little bit earlier on, the odds were stacked in favour of Max Bursak.
An 11-year professional compared to 3 years to Zach Dunn. Actually, interviewed Zach Dunn for the KO Boxing Show, and he mentioned that he used to be a footballer and got injured playing football, and he turned to boxing.
Yep, to get fit and help him overcome those injuries. Lots of footballers do that.
Stop. Football's loss is boxing's gain.
Oh, very much so. Referee Bruce McTavish just warns Max Bursak again. Nice left lead from Bursak. Nice left lead from Zach Dunn.
Bruce will be out to a nightclub tonight, maybe. Who knows, Brucey? Love Machine or someone like that?
Oh, I don't think so, mate. No, not Bruce. I know him too well.
Oh, his wife wouldn't be watching a telecast. Brad, go easy. You don't have to cover for him.
There'll be plenty of people who'll ring and tell her. Don't you worry. Nice left hook by Max Bursak right upon our
probably
commentary
Frank
position.
Will. Frank, don't do it. Gee, this is the spirit about, isn't it?
This fight has started at a very, very hot pace. It started at a hot pace, and we're just going to have to wait for the pace to settle down a little bit, because they're both matching each other with the speed of hand and the power that they both possess. And Zach then just dropped the shoulder in. Referee McTavish said, hey, don't be doing that, Sid.
Yep.
Oh, nice upper body movement by Zach Dunn as he made the left hand.
The club and right hand there, bro.
Yeah, absolutely. Just missing with that right hand. He hasn't found his range yet, Zach. Just missing with that right hand. Bursak sees those punches coming all the time, and the referee warns him again, stop pushing him down. But Bursak wants to bridge that gap, get in close, work where it's safe inside. He's got good short hands. He wants to get inside where he's out of danger.
Who would you say is executing a game plan better right at this stage?
Max Bursak at this stage. He's making Zach miss, and he's hitting him not at will, but he's actually just making him miss and Brett, making his pay. Hasn't hurt Zach at all.
Has Zach Dunn need to do now?
There was a nice clubbing right hand by Zach. What I'd like Zach Dunn to do is take his time. There's a right hand and
down goes Dunn.
Down goes Dunn.
For the first time in his career, he goes down.
First time a clean right hand, but he's okay.
He looked over to his corner and he said he was okay. McTavish is up to 7-8. Dunn's going to go on. There's no doubt he's going to go on. It's the first time. And the bell came at the right time there.
Oh, absolutely. He was off balance when the right hand hit. But
let's go for the replay here. It'd be interesting to see the replay. I'm pretty sure that's the first time Dunn's been down in his career.
I'm sure of it. I am sure of it. Let's have a look.
There we go. The beautiful right hand.
That is a cracker.
That's a home run, nearly.
Absolutely. And he wasn't hurt. You can see Zach there. His leg went from under him. He was he certainly started to look.
And he got up straight away, though.
That showed
a ton of heart, Brett.
What an amazing goal.
Because that was a big shot.
That's amazing.
Oh, big shot. And he showed a ton of heart.
Prior to that, now, our judges have done.
He got up and said, I'm here to stay, though. Yep.
Oh, absolutely. He got immediately straight up. He turned around to his corner and said, I'm all right, I'm not hurt. Just to give his corner some. That'll give Max Bursak
a bit of confidence.
A lot of encouragement, a lot of confidence, because not a renowned punch, just 40% out of 240 rounds, just 40%.
Zach, just box. Give this guy some respect.
Yep, that's what he'll do now.
He's just got a box. Powerful.
He's got a beautiful left lead. Maybe that was a little bit of a wake-up call for Zach Dunn. He needs to stand from the outside. He's standing in no man's land at the moment, Zach Dunn, where he can be hit just like that left lead, and yet he can't hit his opponent.
Let him go, Max.
Pair clinch and Bursak.
This was a major shock to us, Brad.
Well, you know, it was, but as I sort of said, he needs to fight smarter, not harder, because he's got a very, very well-credentialed opponent in here with him, a guy who's been around and fought some of the very best in the world.
What's the next?
This might have put a fire underneath Zach Dunn now.
Oh, absolutely. He needs to, he really needs to start thinking about the task. He misses with the right hand, and then they club each other with left and right to the body. And, you know, the stupid part is, Peter Maniatis, Zach Dunn is actually a very good boxer. He's an intelligent boxer, but he loves to just try and blast him out. There he is getting hit there by left, and again, another left and a right by Max Bursak.
His first world title, Brad. He's got the whole house behind him, and
there's a lot of pressure
going
on this
the
young.
The juices are flowing,
you've got to remember, he's 24 years of age. He's just been a professional for 36 months, just for 3 years.
Nice. Had a big amateur career, though.
Oh, great amateur career. Fought in so many other countries around the world, in Russia, in Thailand, in Ukraine. He's fought in the country that Max Bursak's come from. Left and right by Bursak. Beautiful hands. He's displaying beautiful hands, and his accuracy is there. Zach's just missing the mark at the moment. He hasn't found a range, and he hasn't found a rhythm as yet.
As you said, Max Bursak's had the dream start he wanted.
Oh, absolutely. And it was always going to happen. He's an experienced fighter. He's a professional fighter. That's what he does for a living. He lives, dreams, eats boxing 24-7. Nice left hand.
The young local hero, the Channel 31's been pumping up. We've been right behind him. He's got a hurdle in front of him tonight, Brad.
Oh, absolutely. We've got a long way to go yet. That last round, I don't know how you scored it at home for all of our...
It's a 10-8. It was an
absolute 10-8 round. Well, and a 10-8 round doesn't automatically constitute a knockdown, Pete. But Bursak was winning the round, not by a big margin, but by a little. And then he knocked it. You get 1 point for the win, for winning the round, and you get 1 point only for the knockdown. Nothing more. It's not an automatic 10-8 round, as everyone seems to think. Been a pains during seminars, many countries.
But that was a 10-8 round.
Clear 10-8 round. Yeah. It doesn't get any clearer than that. I'd like to see Zach just not ease off the power a little bit and just let the punches flow. He's too stiff. He's too tight.
I reckon
that's
he's starting
better.
To come
that's
into
better.
It now.
There this is we what go. We want. Nice left hands followed. All everything comes from the left lead. Left, 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 right, left, right. That's better. He's not loading up. He doesn't need to load up.
Do you remind you of Jeff Harding?
He does. Zach he's Dunn. Getting hit there. Another good round for Max Bursak.
I think Zach Dunn's starting to come right in.
He got back into it, but he didn't fight for 3 minutes, Peter Maniatis. Another good round, sadly, for him. Not sadly, I shouldn't say we're being completely neutral here, but another good round for the Ukrainian visitor in Max Bursak.
Here we go again. Zach Dunn and Max Bursak.
Zach Dunn, a local hero from Melbourne, up against Max Bursak from the Ukraine. Both of them exchanging. This is for an IBO world title. Sheepstakes at stakes here tonight at the Royal Exhibition Building.
Absolutely, as we watch some of the production, Zach Dunn needs to work the body a little bit there, going a little bit low there, trying to get the uppercut into play. He needs to find his range. And look, and I said it earlier on before that last exchange over there, he needs to drop the idea that he's going to bowl this bloke over with one punch. You know, this guy has been around. He's a class act. He's had, you know, 200 and...
massive crowd here tonight, as we can see.
240 professional rounds fought compared to Zach Dunn's 66. So Zach needs to match it with him, and he can match it with him. He's got youth on his side. He's got power on his side. He's got agility, and he's got speed.
The local product, Zach Dunn, the boy the whole town's behind here tonight. He started okay, I think, for this, or the last round anyway, Brad. He's starting to work his way back into the
fight. He got back into the round. Now, what he needs to do is convert those opportunities and win the round. At this particular time, I've given him the first round, and he's lost the next three.
Expert comments here from Brad Vercali, international referee and judge. Does a lot of seminars, Brad. We're lucky to have him here on Channel 31. Thanks for coming on board, Brad, and your expert comments, mate. Very well received and very well respected. And the way you're seeing it, the local boys losing the fight early, but it's still early stages.
Oh, absolutely. Look, you know, like, and there's some nice punches by Zach Dunn as he tees off on Max Bursak. Previous to that, Bursak was starting to just tee off on Zach. But look, we've got a long way to go. We're in round number 5 of a 12-round fight, and the boys just bump heads there as Bursak comes in again, gets back on his bike. Another nice right hand by Zach. I'd just like Pete to see that Zach Dunn, instead of just turning off
with
every
shot
punch,
down.
He just needs to let them flow. Let the punches flow. There's the big right hand by Bursak. Left and right, missed by Zach again. He needs to give himself some range. He's got to get himself step out of there. That's it. Step out. Now give yourself some range. Come on, where's that left lead? We know he's got a good left lead. He's just not using it. At this rate,
toe-to-toe stuff, though,
it is. It's toe-to-toe, but that's not the fight he needs. He needs to fight smarter, not harder. And I'll tell you why, if he keeps fighting this fight, sadly, I don't think he's going to win this fight.
We should...
call it as I see it to our fans and friends at home. You know, I'm all behind our Australian fighter, but also I'm certainly behind equality and fairness and equity in judging and scoring as an international ring official. And it's the only way you can see it.
No, fair enough, Brad. And all the viewers out there, it'd be nice to know their opinion on who they think they're winning a fight.
Absolutely. And of course, you know, to our friends watching all around the world back in Ukraine, they'll be watching Team Bursak and the team from K2 Promotions, or probably Vitaly and Vladimir Klitschko will be watching their young charge, Max Bursak, as he challenges for a world title. Hello to everyone in Ukraine, and hello everyone to right across the world, wherever you're watching. And of course, not forgetting our Australian fans in every state of this country who are behind Australia's Zach Dunn. The Dynamo versus the Tiger. It's youth versus experience. It's Dunn versus Bursak.
Brad, you should be a salesman. You are anyway, mate. You're a car salesman. So
you've got all the slogans, mate. I'm a wholesale man, mate.
All the slogans.
Wholesale man.
Next Victorian promotion coming up July 10, Malvern Town. All get down there. 6:30 start. 7:30 first fight. Going to be a good night. Bob Rose Cup.
Another good round. That was a better round. Max Bursak fought for the whole 3 minutes, scored for the whole 3 minutes, but Zach Dunn landed the heavier punches, and we'll see a little bit of this in the replay in just a moment. And I'm going to go out. I'm not going to sit on the fence. I actually reckon Zach Dunn stole this round, right? Just by sheer of weight of punches. Now, look, when I've travelled overseas, I've changed my scoring criteria a little bit, because in overseas, a lot of the overseas judges, power beats work rate. Out here in Australia and in some parts of England, work rates beat power. But there we can see Zach Dunn starting to find his range. Just misses there a little bit. But the punches that he did land were powerful. Just watch this. Right, there's the right hand that hits.
Toe-to-toe stuff.
He gets another one there. Watch this. The right hand right to the ribcage.
Big body shots there from Dunn.
Look, a very close round. Toss of the coin. Me, I go for Zach Dunn on that round. Power beat work rate. Nothing more.
Danny Kay, as we said, Zach walked into the gym as a 13-year-old boy. 11 years later, they're in the world title fight. Great story. Ran here, round 6, nearly the halfway mark for his IBO super middleweight world title. Max Bursak from Kiev, Ukraine, in the black shorts.
up against Zach Dunn in a navy blue shorts with a white
pipe. It's a two-point fight on my unofficial scorecard at the moment. I score it 48-46 in favour of the visitor, Max Bursak. And I'm sure that Zach Dunn, as the fight goes on, will find his range, he'll find a rhythm, and he'll start to find a home for his power punches. But right at the moment, he needs to be able to get his range and get his rhythm in there. Bursak working the body very, very good with a double-fisted attack right there as he backs into the neutral corner. Referee Bruce McTavish got the best seat in the house here. Can watch every little punch as it comes.
Don't push.
This has been to and fro from the start, Brett.
Oh, it has, yep.
And as we mentioned before, whatever happens, this is going to improve Zach Dunn as a fighter.
Oh, clearly. You know, experience fighting a guy like the likes of Max Bursak. And, you know, as I said a little earlier on, Pete, you know, this fight is as interesting as it is awkward. It's an awkward fight for Dunn, but he has got the tools. And it's going to be down. Look, this fight could be won down the stretch, Pete, in rounds 10, 11, 12, the championship rounds. You notice Max Bursak is doing a little bit what Jay Mitchell did a little bit earlier on. He's waiting for Zach Dunn to expire. When his punches are expired, then he throws his own punches. Copped a couple for his effort there. Lefts and rights by Bursak. Right hand, left hook by Bursak. Left hook by Dunn. The powerful punches coming from Zach Dunn. The more punches coming from Max Bursak. Beautiful right hook and right uppercut by Zach Dunn.
This is what Australian boxing, Victorian boxing is all about, though, isn't it?
Oh, sensational stuff.
Well, Zach Dunn's really got to dig in just to be in the fight, doesn't he? There's coasting.
No, he can't. There's no room for coasting here. Now, referee Bruce McTavish, I can't hear what he's saying. I think he's giving Max a warning for either hitting on the break or holding, one of the two. I know that when Max Bursak fought Jared Fletcher over in Monaco,
big right hand.
That certainly caught the attention of Max Bursak. Oh, the punishing right hand to the body, by left hook to the body.
Bruce is taking a point off.
He's going to take a point. I don't know what for.
He said for headbutting. This is even the fight right up now.
Wow. Yep, he's ordered it.
International referee Bruce McTavish from the Philippines is just taking a point off.
Okay, he's taking a point from Max for a headbutt.
And this has evened it right up now, Brett.
It certainly has.
This takes away the knockdown.
Absolutely. Well, it's an interesting situation because I gave Zach Dunn the round, 10-9, minus the 10. Of course, Zach's wailing away there. Yep.
Now, Zach Dunn counters with his heavy shots. Big shots in there with Zach Dunn.
Right.
Punching in between the gloves, which means you're an accurate puncher.
Absolutely.
If you do that, Brett.
Yep. Let's see if we can see where the head came together here.
Both catching left hooks.
I can't see the head, but there it is there. He stuck the head right in the chin of Zach Dunn, and referee Bruce McTavish warned him before, and obviously.
We can have a local hero here tonight. Imagine Zach.
Round number seven.
Here we go. Zach Dunn and Max Bursak for the vacant IBO super middleweight world title. The fight's just about even, Brad.
Very much. I have it as 57 Bursak or 56 Bursak, 56 Dunn. And there's some nice left and rights by Max Bursak. Nice little punches. No power in them, but they're good scoring punches. And that's what our judges are looking at. For the folks at home, let me tell you what would have happened in that last round. We're using the 10-point scoring must system. The winner of the round receives 10 points. The loser, a lesser point, whether it be 10-9 or whether it be 10-8. In this case here, Zach Dunn won the round in my unofficial card, so he scored at 10-9. And then Max Bursak lost a point, so he would have been 10-9. And the 1 point will come off his final tally, right? So at this particular stage, that 1 point could hurt him a little bit down the stretch. But right at the moment,
both
on my unofficial card...
Both fighters are really weighing away now, Brad.
Yeah, absolutely.
As we said before, sheep station's up for tonight. The winner gets a massive payday, let's be quite honest. It sets up the international career. The loser... It's a lot of building
from here. And,
you know,
let me tell you this. There's some great domestic fights had to be had in the super middleweight division yet from in and around Australia,
like,
too, for,
who
for
would
the
you
winner
like?
Of this fight. Well, when you think about it, look, you know, you've got the likes of Rowan Murdoch in Queensland. You've got Blake Caparello. The super middleweight division has been
sure,
very,
Sure, Blake's watching
you know?
And Sam.
Oh, absolutely. You know, what a great professional team they are, you know. So, but, oh, there's that beautiful left lead for from Max Bursak. Snaps the head back
great
of Zach Dunn, who's bridged the gap. As we're in round number 7 of a 12 three-minute rounds for the IBO World Super Middleweight title.
What's ahead?
It's Dunn versus Bursak here at the iconic Royal Exhibition Buildings in the Melbourne suburb of Carlton. I hope you're enjoying your World Championship fight on TV.
Oh, Zach Dunn now starting to wail off. Starting to find his range, Brad, isn't he?
He has. He's found his range. But listen, let me tell you this. Max Bursak's not done with yet. Referee Bruce McTavish warns him for pushing his opponent away. There's that little uppercut. Lefts and rights by Bursak again. Dunn comes back with a clubbing left hook. Just
Tavish
missed the mark.
Breaks him up.
Left and right by Bursak. That hit the mark.
This is toe-to-toe stuff.
Oh, this is...
This is TV ringside back in your
really
lounges.
Is.
This
is
an old-school scrap.
Old-school brawl.
From an Eastern European tough guy up against our local Aussie. Could have been a digger 30 or 40 years ago.
Could have been. He is
old Aussie spirit.
And of course, the Dunn family, Harry Dunn, I trained with many years ago, but trained down here in Brunswick. Fought TV ringside. Harry Dunn comes in. Come from a
Bobby
fighting
Dunn
family.
As well.
No, no relation. Bobby Dunn, our former, rest in peace, may you rest in peace, Bobby, the former Australian and Commonwealth featherweight champion. Good friend of mine. Oh. We sparred many rounds. And they're at it left and right, the pair of these two guys. And another good round for Zach Dunn.
Is there any guys you haven't sparred with, Brett? You've sparred with
amazing.
More guys
you know,
than
at 14 years old, I've sparred Pamo, I've sparred Lionel, I've sparred Nick Natalson.
Big right hand there from Bursak.
Let's have a look at some of the action there. Bursak stands in here, admires his work. You watch, he's about to get clubbed here. There's a beautiful left lead by Max. There's the left lead again. He stands here, watching his work. Starting to mark up around the top of the... There's the
shots
left
there from Dunn.
What? There's that little right uppercut.
Big
there's
left
the left
there from
another
Dunn.
One. Right hand by Bursak. It's punch for punch. What we've seen there, Peter Maniatis, is this. Earlier in the fight, Max Bursak was doing his work getting in and getting out. Right now, he's doing his work getting in and standing there admiring what's happened. And, of course, he's not relying on the punches that are coming from Zach Dunn, because with Zach Dunn, there's always another punch coming.
Expert comments from Brad Bacall, international referee, flying in today
from
sunny Gold Coast.
Wasn't too sunny up there this morning, let me tell you, Peter. It was a bit chilly, but it's chillier down here. But the action in centre ring here at the iconic Melbourne Exhibition and Convention Centre has... Sorry, it's not the Melbourne Exhibition, it's Melbourne.
It's okay, oh, Brad. Golly. You've had a big day, mate. I know you have.
It's been a long day, and I'm really excited about this fight.
Well, this is main event.
Look
this is what we're here for.
Left lead of Max Bursak.
For the viewers out there, it takes so much time and effort for each fighter to be in this position. So many wins, getting in the ratings, petitioning, getting a position, waiting for the title to arrive, making the matchups, a lot of money and effort.
And, of course, even the logistics of putting a world championship fight on here.
Well, you put Randy Pettle-Corrin's fight on, you can explain
that. WBA world interim champion.
A big favourite at Channel 31. We love Randy.
Absolutely, and what a wonderful little fighter. And let me tell you this, he's managed by you, and, well, he might be a Filipino, but we've claimed him as an Australian.
Barry's to the Western Bulldogs.
Does he really?
Yeah.
Okay, I won't hold that against him, but,
well,
but let me tell you.
For, Brent?
Oh, Brisbane Lions now. Oh. Brisbane Lions. Fitzroy. I'm always an old Fitzroy. We're a happy team at Fitzroy.
You didn't start barracking for him in 2001 when they started winning flags, did you, Brent?
I started with Lionel, and I used to go way back into the 70s and the 80s. We'd go to Fitzroy.
Okay. Who's their current captain?
At the moment is Tommy Rockliffe.
Thank you, Brett. You're right on the ball. You didn't know who our first Prime Minister was, though, did you?
Oh, no, I did, but I just couldn't remember it. We still haven't found out. And thanks to my nephew, Rowan, he just sent me a text saying that...
Rowan, I'm keeping Brett on his toes, don't worry.
And to my brother, Don, and all the family up there at Craigieburn, I'm wishing you all well, and I hope you're enjoying the fights from tonight. Hopefully I get a chance to catch up with you guys before I head back to the Goldie tomorrow.
Oh, you should, Brad.
I hope so. I've got to go and do
You've
a bit of shopping.
You've got the hide car.
The Victorian market's here. Let's get back to the fight, of course.
Zach Dunn's starting to will his way into the fight, isn't he? He's all heart, this kid.
The power is starting to take its toll a little bit on Max Bursak. He's getting marked up. I see Max just getting hit with single little punches like that, where that wasn't happening in the early part of the round, in the early part of the fight.
He's heavy-handed, Zach Dunn, isn't he?
Very heavy-handed. Well, you don't be heavy-handed if you can't be heavy-handed if you've got 15 knockouts in 17 wins and an 88% knockout record.
He's a goer. He's at you all the time. Even if you land shots, he's at you all the time. There's no break.
How'd you be fighting him in the back lane on a dark, rainy night?
Not too good, Brad.
I don't think you beat him with a shotgun. Max Bursak comes in, trying to work the body again, trying to bridge the gap, trying to get out of the range of Zach Dunn. Club's done with a little left hook there on his way out. There's that left lead starting to miss now. Dunn seeing the punches coming very, very
Dunn's
well.
Dunn's developing head movement all of a sudden as well. He's learning, isn't he?
Absolute.
He's becoming a better fighter right in front of us here tonight.
He certainly has. There's he standing there admiring his
work. Big shots from both fighters.
Again.
This is what it's all about, Brad. Another
good round. That was a better round by Max Bursak. I don't think he did enough to win the round, but a better round by Max Bursak.
And Ukraine versus Australia, our main event.
It's an interesting round.
Brad's always peeping over at the judges' scorecard. Are you running a live?
No, I can't.
You are, mate. Are you running a live betting thing or something?
Not at all. Not at all. I'm just putting my own slant on it.
Ron Reed's on the computer. They're all here now. He's got the Wi-Fi burning. Midnight oil stuff. I bet he's not on Facebook. I bet he's doing other stuff, Ron Reed. Who knows? He could be on Facebook. No. Ron, are you working or are you on Facebook, mate? Well, mate, you've been watching a judge's scorecard throughout the night. Brad, I'd love to know who's winning because I'll get on live bet.
I can't.
You know, you're sneaking over, scorecard. Mate. I'm sorry.
No, I was actually looking at the ring card.
Round number 9.
You've just given me up. Back to the action in round number 9. On my unofficial scorecard, I have 76-74 in favour of the Dynamo, Zach Dunn, over the Tiger, Max Bursak from the Ukraine.
Max just starting to really
feel that body shot actually hurt Zach Dunn then. The left rip by Max Bursak certainly hurt Zach Dunn there. Caught his attention. There's the little uppercut again.
Zach's won most of the middle round. This is where he needs it.
He certainly has.
He needs a finish.
I've given him the last four rounds.
He needs a finish.
Not by a lot. There's nothing in it. And the judges could have gone either way because Bursak has been busy.
Here we go again, toing and throwing, as we keep mentioning. Brad, this fight can go either way.
Oh, absolutely, it can go either way.
Break it.
What a great matchup. The matchup that this has happened is worthy of a version of the World Championship. Oh, beautiful left lead by Bursak. There's the left hook by Bursak, trying to bridge that gap, get inside the range, the power range of Zach Dunn, and that's what he has done.
Big
very
body
well
shot there from Dunn.
Nice little right uppercut.
Zach's, in my opinion, his next fight, he's going to improve 10 or 15% from this, well, whoever
you know,
he fights.
Early days, I've had a lot to do with this young man, and I've seen him fight. Every fight he comes out, he gets better every fight.
There's a big future for this kid.
Oh, absolutely. He is the future of Australian boxing. So wherever you may be watching on Channel 31, right round Australia as Max Bursak goes with a double-fisted attack. I hope you're enjoying our coverage live from Melbourne.
Let him go, Max.
Another big body shot. Oh, they're great, aren't they? Because
what about how tough Max Bursak is? I mean, he's copped a lot of good hard shots to the body this evening.
He's defeated Brian Vera. He gave Mark Murray a tough fight. Of course he's going to be tough.
He certainly did, yep. He doesn't travel well out of five fights away
back,
from
Max,
his home Ukraine. He's been beaten three times.
You're getting technical again, Brad.
Oh, it's just a little bit of knowledge that I learned on Boxrec. Big right hand by Dunn. Just caught the edge of...
Expert comments from Brad Bacala. Great to have him here, Brad. You've been a great sport. You've put up with me all night. And I've been having massive shots at you. You're still smiling.
Oh,
yeah,
mate.
Throwing the mic
I know, Pete. We still love you.
Oh, big body shots there from Dunn.
The
and that's
body
what
shots
he needs
are really
to do.
Starting to take their toll on Max. He slowed down dramatically as he takes a deep breath. Look at that beautiful left lead. Is he brave, this young guy? Left and right. Left hook to the body and left hook to the head by Dunn.
We know they're watching. Even Sean Buckley might even be watching this from Altitude.
Good chance. Yep, absolutely from Altitude. Sean, great supporter of the boxing. Professional boxing. Yeah.
That's it of round number 9, ladies and gentlemen. 3 rounds remain. And we'll find out IBO super middleweight champion of the world.
Body shots there from Dunn. Some great body shots. But look, you know, Bursak was still in it, wasn't he? You know, there's the left hook on the break, which was really nice punch by Zach Dunn. There's always, you know, the good part about Zach Dunn is work ethic. There's always a punch coming, isn't there? You know,
Mick Hargrave's in the corner there with Daryl Ford, Danny Kaye, and the other gentleman that's putting the ice on top of his head. Who's that? Like the first Prime Minister of Australia, you're going to give me that neutral answer, but now I do. Tell me he's a great mate of yours. Oh, you'll put me on the line. You're a bugger, Brad. You knew the captain was a Brisbane, though. I'll give you that.
Yeah, we're lucky guess. Lucky guess. Round number 10 of the World Championship, the IBO World Championship.
Round number 10.
Max Bursak from Ukraine versus Zach Dunn from Melbourne, Australia. Nice triple left hand by Zach Dunn. Left hooks, right hook to the body. Double fisted attack on the back move by Dunn. Close fight. Bursak drops the head in again. Referee Bruce McTavish had a look and doesn't like it. Oh, left hook by Bursak. Another left hook by Bursak. He's got Zach Dunn back in his own corner.
Dunn's got to get off the
ropes.
Bruce
is going to warn him for the head there. He just put his hand on his head and said, hey, get your head out of it.
Zach's better off in the middle.
Oh, there's a powerful left hook by Bursak as he caught Zach on the back move. Zach needs to get some lateral movement going. Don't go straight back in a line. Go back in a straight line.
Get off the ropes.
Yep, he's got to get off those ropes. He's got to stop going back in the straight line. There he is. Gets under the right hand. There he gets hit with a left hand. He uses his own left lead. Oh, great stuff. They're both equal to the task. Two absolute champions. Left and right by Bursak. He's really up the ante in this round. He's actually sneaking this round away from Zach Dunn. Got him on the back, left and right, and left and right by gain by Zach Dunn. And Zach drops the head in. Oh, right. God, keep the head out of it.
Back to centre ring. Zach Dunn, as we mentioned, a local hero. Big campaign behind Channel 31.
Let him go, Max.
TV ringside back, basically, because Zach
Dunn's
here. Oh,
left and right by Bursak. Better round by Max Bursak. Sorry, Pete. This is really starting to hot up. The action is really close in there. Bursak is really up the ante in this round. Oh, left and right. He's hurt Zach. He's hurt Zach Dunn. Zach's in a little bit of strife, but he fights back.
Oh, what a warrior Zach Dunn is.
Oh, God, left and right by Bunn. Oh, they're getting nasty in there now. As Zach.
It's a world title, Brad. Wow. You've got to get nasty.
No second guesses.
This is
don't get angry,
Zach
get
up.
Even. Don't get angry, get
that's
even. Work, fight smarter, not harder.
All the slogans from Brad McCarley.
Oh, this fight is deeply in the balance on my unofficial scorecard. 85-84 in favour of the Victorian Zach Dunn. Max Bursak turning up the wick in round number 10 in the championship round. Zach looks like he's exhausted. His mouth is open as he fights for dear life. Left hook by Bursak again. That was a slip.
A slip. That's a slip.
But that's Zach looks a little unsteady on his feet. I have to say that left hook certainly hurt him.
I think he's okay.
Beautiful body shot. He dug that into the ribs there.
Didn't he?
Left and right by Dunn again. Left and right by Bursak as he tries to get inside the power range of Zach Dunn. He's done that very effectively in this 10th round.
Great.
The championship rounds are yet to come. Who's going to bring home the 2 pounds of gold? Zach Dunn with left and right to the body. Right hand by Dunn. Blood bleeding from the mouth now, Zach Dunn. Left and right by Zach Dunn. Left
this is what it's all about, Brad. This is what it's all about.
What an amazing fight. Oh, what a
rear
fight. What an absolute round of boxing. The best round of the fight so far. Another round on my unofficial scorecard, Peter Maniatis. I've had to go with Max Bursak. Let's have a look at some of the better
nice
action
body
in this round.
There from Dunn.
There's the left hook by Bursak. Dunn misses with his punch. Another left and right by there. Is he hurt, Zach, with those punches? Let's have a look. There's the uppercut. Let's watch the left hook. There it is again. Left lead again. Look at the blood starting to flow from the mouth. There's the left hook. Right on the right hand. And the left hook.
But Dunn's tough. He wore him and he kept coming
tough.
Back.
Tough is an under description of Zach Dunn as he fights back. Look at that left hook again. Right on the nose. And Zach there. And Bursak with the equaliser.
as we mentioned, a lot of Jeff Harding about Zach Dunn.
Absolutely. Wow, at the end of the 10th round on my unofficial scorecard.
Round number 11.
Peter Maniatis, I have it 94-94. How are you scoring at home, wherever you may be? Am I biased? Am I wrong? I hope I'm not wrong. I hope I'm right. It's a very, very good even fight.
It's an even fight, Brandon. It's a great fight. And what a way to bring TV ringside back into the lounge rooms in a fight like this.
And to Barry Michael and the team, to Barry and Sue and Craig Dunn, congratulations.
People are watching it at home and have got normal TV. They haven't got Foxtel. Over a pizza and a beer. How magnificent is this?
Mate, that sounds better than what we're doing here behind the microphone. I can tell you that sounds very good to me.
Mate, you grabbed all the bloody sweets that were here, Brad. They went in about 5 seconds.
I'm going to fight you for them. The pair tie up in centre ring. The pace has dropped off. The hand speed hasn't dropped off, but the pace of the fight has dropped off dramatically. The urgency's still there. The want is still there. The desire is still there. Styles make fights. Who's going to come home in these championships rounds? 10, 11 and 12. As referee Bruce McTavish.
Bursak's really marked up around the face, isn't he?
Time. Now, what's happening here? He's calling the doctor. Oh, Zach Dunn has a cut.
Time for an accidental headbutt in center.
Accidental head clash, and Zach Dunn has been cut. I can't see what eye we're talking about.
I don't think it's major.
No, it doesn't look very. The doctor is just pushing his hand to try and stem the bleeding, and no, it's all okay.
It's all okay.
Just,
let's
just
go.
A matter of
diamond.
Minor repairs, as we say in the minor pit stop.
Going to take a lot more than a cut eye to stop the dynamo, Zach Dunn. And
the pair goes right
centering again. And Bursak talks to Dunn. He's sort of, I don't know what he said.
He said, "You'll be paying for the doctors later." And Zach said, "No,
I'm not up to date. I'm not up to date on my Ukrainian language at the moment. With Aboriginal being my first language, Australian my second." Oh, Dunn, Bursak backs Dunn onto the ropes. Zach trying to find that range. There's that lovely left lead again. Nice left lead by
Bursak. This fight's up for grab.
It certainly is.
Brad, let's be quite honest. Anyone could win this now.
Oh, absolutely. How are you seeing at home? I hope you're enjoying tonight's coverage World Champion.
Text me if you've got my number. Tassie Brown just sent the text.
Good hello to Grant down in Tassie. Oh, it's a hard fight. There's no room for the faint-hearted in centre ring. Dunn gets hit by a hard left hook. He clubs Max Bursak with a right hand as referee Bruce McTavish breaks him up. A little bit of blood coming from the inner, from a cut on the bridge of the nose of Zach Dunn. This is his hardest fight. He's now into the 10th round. He hasn't gone 10 rounds.
Some good shots there from Dunn. The whole crowd's going nuts now.
Oh, the crowd are on their feet here.
The local Melbourne boy. With the world at his feet right at the moment, Brad.
Absolutely.
He's looking at a world title right here, live in a Channel 31. Can Zach Dunn bring the IBO world title back home?
Break it.
The pair lock up again. Referee Bruce McTavish breaks him. It's a good, hard, close fight. Both guys have had their moments. Both guys are keen. Both guys want it.
Oh, some big shots landed from
left
both guys.
By, nice left hook.
This
by
is a war, Brad.
It is absolutely a war.
End of round number 11.
What a fight.
Let's make some noise, Melbourne. One round remains to find out IBO super middleweight champion of the world. Will it be the Tiger Max Bursak or Zach Dynamo Dunn? One round remains at TV Ringside's main event live on Channel 31.
See, Dunn landing nice jabs.
Beautiful little jabs. I gave Dunn that round just by sheer of power. The work rate and the power. But the punches and
hands landed,
the heavy hands at one point. Look at that, those punches there. When they did land, they had a visible effect on his opponent. But take nothing away from the Ukraine's Max Bursak, because he's in this fight. Round number 11 is in the books. And we come for the 12th and final round.
Let's make some noise,
the championship round, mate.
Absolutely.
It's up for grabs here.
This is the 12th and
a big
final round.
In the fight, Brett. He
Here we go. Round number 12, the championship round. Dunn versus Bursak, Australia versus Croatia, versus Ukraine.
Great. Max.
The pair lock up and referee Bruce McTavish breaks again. Fight's been fought in relatively good spirits. It's been fought hard. It's been fought fair. A couple of little misdemeanors earlier in the round, in the fight.
Great.
It's been fought in great spirit, though, hasn't it?
Absolutely.
Both of them have been good sportsmen.
Absolutely. They've got a little bit heated at different times of the fight there.
They've been great sportsmen.
But that's to be expected. There's a lot on the line here for these young guys. These young Lions, these young Turks, they are the future of our sport.
Here we go again.
I have a 1-point advantage to the Australian, Zach Dunn.
But he needs a big, let's hope he has a big round.
Right,
he needs a big round to finish.
Absolutely, he does. Referee McTavish asked Max Bursak, keep your head out of it. Zach really looking for the finisher here. He needs to, there's a nice left lead, double left leads. What Zach Dunn doesn't need to do now is be heavy foot and flat footed. He needs to keep on the move, keep those, the hands, he just needs to keep the hands flowing. Let them flow, just let them come. The punch will come.
Punch out, put out.
We know he's got the skill, we know he's got the stamina. He's gone, this is the longest he's gone in any of his professional fights.
He's done 12 rounds on his head.
Absolutely. Oh, he gets clubbed with a left hook, but a right, nice hard right hand to the body by Zach Dunn.
As we mentioned before, a lot of Jeff Hitman hard.
Referee Bruce McTavish warned Zach for dropping the shoulder in again. And Todd, nice right hand by Bursak. This is going to be an interesting finish to this fight, Pete. How have the judges seen it, and how have you seen it at home? Nice left rip to the body.
Powerful punch by Zach Dunn.
A minute to go before we could have our new world champion, Brad. The crowd going
Alexander
nuts.
Alexander Krasiuk in the corner, urging Max Bursak to come on. Urging him lefts and rights. Both boys want it. It's close. It's hard.
Short right hand there from Dunn. Let's go to the home stretch.
Left
here.
Double left hook by Bursak. Nice left lead.
Dunn
left hook
to
by
the
Bursak
body.
Again. Dunn misses with that hook to the body. Misses with the right hand. Lovely left hook by Bursak. Left hook again by Bursak.
Good evasive skills from Dunn.
Oh, this is an amazing contest for the championship of the world. The super middleweight, the IBO, the International Boxing Organization championship.
20 seconds
of the world.
To go. Here we go. For Sheep Stations here, we're talking world titles live into your TV screens. Zach Dunn might be 10 seconds away from Australia's
amazing.
New world
here
champion.
Here we go. Bursak tries to finish off strong.
Who do you like? Big left
and
there it
is.
That is the end of the ladies and
both
gentlemen.
Boys raise their arms in triumph.
We go to the judges' scorecards to find our winner of our main event, TV Ringside. Can I please have Gary Simmons of Simmons Homes to centering, please?
See some of the action in this last and final round. 12 rounds after 12 rounds, the boys put it all on the line. And we'll leave the decision up to our expert judges. Judge David Craig, the president of the New Zealand National Boxing Federation, has joined us here tonight in Australia. And he has done New Zealand proud. Judge Churchanon Suryat, I've worked with him a number of times, and a good judge. Kriansak Kong Hong. And our referee from the Philippines, Mr. Bruce McTavish, done a wonderful job tonight, kept control of the fight. There's nothing I would expect Bruce not to do. 70-something years of age, and he's still sprightly as he travels around the world refereeing fights. How did you see it at home? On my unofficial card, let me tell you, I had 114-113 in favour of Australia's Zach Dunn. It wasn't by much, it wasn't pretty at times, but it was hard, and both boys deserved an excellent round of applause. The crowd is on its feet here at the Melbourne Royal Exhibition Buildings. And it's an amazing night by that young man, Zach Dunn, and his promoter, Barry Michael. And, well, they can be proud with themselves. It's close, it's hard, it could go either way. I've got a sneaking feeling that Zach Dunn has got away and stolen the fight after suffering a knockdown in round number 3. It wasn't a flash knockdown. It was as clean as they come. And Max Bursak looked at that particular time, looked a better fighter. He found his range. He had a rhythm. Looked like he was going to get on top. And then the dynamo, Zach Dunn, fought it out to the very, very end and might have come home and steal the world championship belt. The crowd is in expectance here tonight. Everyone's on their feet. Everyone is in expectance. It's an amazing performance by Australia's Zach Dunn. And, of course, Max Bursak with the Ukraine crew over there standing as we await the official decision. Let's go up to our ring announcer, Mr. John Demercoli.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 12 rounds of boxing action, we've gone to the judges' scorecards. Your judges score the contest. David Craig scored the contest 116-110. Judge Sitcherat scored the contest 115-111. Your third judge, Krinsak, scored this contest 115-111. Declaring your winner by unanimous points and your new IBO super middleweight champion of the world, Red Corner, Zach Dynamo Dunn!
And there it is, the new world super middleweight champion, Australia's Zach Dunn, by scores of 116-110, 115-111, 115-111 again. I had 115-113. Amazing performance by Zach Dunn. Come off the deck to score a memorable victory here in Melbourne tonight. Let's go upstairs and listen to Peter Maniatis as he interviews the new world champion.
Back here at the Royal Exhibition Buildings, a new world champion, Zach Dunn, and now the future of Australian boxing. Give him a round of support. Barry, you can't help it. You can do that later, mate. We'll finish the interview for a second. Zach, growing up as a kid, you must have been dreaming of this moment right now. What's going through your mind?
There's a plan, like it's like a roller coaster up in there. First things first, I just like to thank my coach, Danny. He's been with me since the beginning. If everyone can put their hands together for Danny, my trainer.
Yeah!
My father is in the background, you know, doesn't like to be mentioned, but without him, I couldn't have been here today, so thanks, Dad.
Get in here, Craig. Mate, you bit the dust early in the fight. What did you think when you got back up? Because you looked straight at your corner.
It was just a quick flash, you know. It didn't rock me or nothing, you know. But I got up and bounced back, you know. I was taking my hand off, you know, like you made me work for it, which is, you know, exactly what I needed. I need to go to 12 rounds to finish this IBO. I'd like to thank everyone for coming out. Thank you, everyone.
What's next now for Zach Dunn? Because you've got the world at your feet. You fought live all around Victoria and Australia today, so you can't get any better, mate. You're undefeated. You talk to the town. You've got Ron Reed riding for you in a Herald Sun. There's a lot of Jeff Hitman Hardy about you. I said that during the commentating. What's next for you? What do you want to do next?
For the next couple of weeks, I just want to enjoy the IBO, you know, celebrate a little bit. But, the WBA next up, I want to have Abraham in Germany. I want to bring it back to Australia and bring exciting fights back to Australia.
That's what we want. Neil, before we sign you off, mate, what's on for tonight? There's got to be a few beers. Barry's your promoter. Barry's not a camel. He loves a drink. So what's on for tonight?
We're at Bar Central in Lygon Street, so come back and have a drink with us. I've got to say, ladies and gentlemen, everyone who supported Dave Dunn and Zach Dunn and I and put this promotion together, thank you so much. I've got to thank my wife Sue's done a magnificent job and all the girls she's employed. But look, I've also got to say Max Bursak, what a great fighter and what a great world title fight. We're going to go on a bigger and better thing, but I'd just like to say all these guys from the Ukraine, they're real sportsmen, they came to win and it was a fantastic world title fight. Thank you so much. Thank you, Victoria. Thank you, Australia. Well done, Zach. And we're going to go to Monaco now. We're going to fight the winner of Abraham and Steiglitz, and we're going to win that world title too.
Zach, before we sign you off, like a quick, just a quick cheerio to everyone.
Yeah, just thanks to everyone. Thanks to my partner. Darryl Ford and Nick Hargraves. Thanks for the wonderful work in the corner.
Legend Nick Hargraves, here you go, Darryl Ford, the priest. All right, mate, how did you feel about the result? Are you happy with what's going on?
Хочу поблагодарить всех зрителей за атмосферу, которую создали у ринга.
First of all, I'd like to thank all the spectators for the beautiful atmosphere around the ring.
Мои поздравления за Кутана.
And my best congratulations to Zach Khan. Thank you so much.
What's next for you now, Max? What's next? Anything?
Движемся дальше, бомбардировки.
I will go on boxing.
Okay, congratulations. Thanks for coming to Australia. Great sports from the Ukraine. Thank you everyone for turning up and supporting Channel 31 Live Boxing, and hopefully we can come back to you pretty soon. Well done, Barry, I'll leave it to you.
Okay, look, I just say once again, ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for the great sportsmanship from this man and his team. And just an absolutely fantastic night of boxing. All my dear friends and supporters and Craigs and Zachs, just thank you so much. Let's go back to Bar Central and celebrate. But thank you. Zach Dunn goes on to bigger and better things. That was a real world title fight you saw tonight. It doesn't get much better than that. Thank you, everyone.
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the entire team here this evening, we thank you so much for watching. We were live at the Melbourne Royal Exhibition Centre. My name is John Zimacoli. It was an honour and a pleasure to be your MC throughout this evening. To all the winners tonight, congratulations. To the runners-up, commiserations. Till next time, stay safe, and we'll see you back here in Centre Ring for Barry Michaels TV Ringside.
You know you spend two-thirds of your life working and paying tax so you can relax and enjoy the next third. But the fact is, without a proven plan, being financially comfortable will be unachievable for most people. For nearly 20 years, Custodian has been helping thousands of people just like you create an income for life, pay off their homes quicker, and reduce tax. So take the first step. Call 1300 135 507 or go online.
Visit custodian.com.au.
Here's the product that's causing a revolution in garden edging, Formboss. It's the simple, durable, and great-looking answer to getting your garden edging right. This steel edging can be easily formed on site to create any curves or angles you require and is guaranteed to last 10 years in the ground. Formboss is essentially maintenance-free, easy to install, and comes in a range of sizes and finishes. Visit formboss.com.au to locate your nearest reseller or to order. Formboss, your complete edging solution.
Don't pay full retail. Come to Seconds World for huge savings on factory seconds, carton damage, run out, showroom models and brand new appliances. All in perfect working order. All direct from the manufacturer. All with the manufacturer's warranty. Save hundreds on a tiny scratch. Save hundreds on a torn carton. There's bargains every day of the week. Save on demos and display models. Come in and check it out. Seconds World, 10 Nicholson Street, Coburg. Call 1300 Seconds. Quality factory seconds at fantastic prices.
GreenCareFunerals.com.au. Thinking of building a new home or granny flat? Premier can meet all your needs. With over 40 years' experience, they are proud to provide the highest quality customer service. Clients can work with Premier's team that is dedicated to designing a home you'll love to live in. As you plan for your future security, Premier takes care of all the worries, including plans and permits. Their 10-home display village is open 7 days. Or go online to premierhomesvic.com.au. Premier Homes, keeping families together.
Interested in marketing your business on TV? For the money it costs you to buy just one spot on some stations, you could buy this many spots on ours. C31 Melbourne and Geelong. More spots, more value, more customers.
back here, Brad, at the Royal Exhibition Buildings. What a stunning performance we saw from Zach Dunn to win the vacant IBO Super Middleweight World title. I'm sure it's going to bring him to bigger and better things.
Well, Peter, it was a real arm wrestle the whole way. You know, Max Bursak got out of the blocks very, very well. Looked like he was going to come home. He knocked Zach Dunn down in the third round, and things didn't look really good. Zach Dunn bit their heart down on the mouth guard, and he worked his way back into the fight. The body punches took their toll. Then he changed his attack from the body to the head, and he started to work Max Bursak out. Max slowed down a little bit. The shine came off him after around six rounds. Four rounds in a row, Zach Dunn came home, and he just snuck home with a victory. 115-111. It was about right, I think. It was an excellent performance. But more importantly, the entire night, Peter Maniatis, was an excellent night. Welcome back, TV Ringside. It's just absolutely fabulous. We've just turned back the clock, and this is going to be something sensational. As we look at some of the better value of the fight during the entire fight, and it's just terrific stuff. You can see there the body punches, the beautiful left lead by Zach Dunn. He's got a great left lead. I said it earlier in the fight. He just wasn't using it. So there we have it. It's been a wonderful night, Peter Manning. It's been great to have your company here with us as well.
Yep. Thank you, Channel 31. And as we say, keep punching.